Helen, and this one is going to be a Pilates class. So imagine we're all together at the Ryland Centre. So grab a mat, weights if you have them, or water bottles or something. As ever, listen to your body. If I'm saying to do something and it doesn't feel right for your body, then listen to that. Modify, tweak it, make a little adjustment. And if that doesn't sort you, then leave it out because we will soon be moving on. But enjoy. So pop in, just pop your weights down for a minute and coming into centre of your mat. So walk the toes out, walk the heels out, rock that weight forward and back, thinking about lengthening up through the spine, opening through the collarbone so you gently nestle the shoulders down. This isn't ramming them down, you just let them drift away from the ears. And then lastly, imagine that length through the back of the neck. So imagine that peach between chin and chest. Bring your feet to a standstill, hands onto hips, soften through the knees. And we'll start with our pelvic tilts. So you're thinking hips coming up to ribs to lengthen tailbone down. And then rolling hips away to stick tailbone out. So you might want to bridge that gap, hip to rib, to tuck under and lengthen. You might prefer hand front and back. You might want to keep hands onto ribs and check they're staying still and the movement's being led from the pelvis. So you should still find that shoulders stuck over ribs and it's your tailbone, pelvis that's moving and working. The softer your knees, the more range you're going to get. So then find your neutral. So you've got a gentle lengthen down on that tailbone. You can feel a bit of a connection with the hip, but as you take a breath in, you can still breathe into that belly. Still expanding as you breathe in and breathing out, everything melts back down. Lengthen through the legs, check you're still into that neutral. Let's get warm. So we're going to start with a shoulder roll on the left, right, shoulder roll on the right and gliding down back into centre. Other side, shoulder roll and a glide down, back in and again, roll it. Lengthen. This time you can let the other arm drift up and back into centre. Shoulder roll, left. Glide it down, open up the hand, back into centre. Other side, roll it and glide. Looking up at that top hand now. And we're going to take this to a ragged doll. So you're going to sweep that hand over to your left, right, sorry, down. Into centre, stack it back up. Other side. So shoulder roll and lengthen. Look at that top hand. So to keep that right hand rolling round to your left. Into the middle. Knees nice and soft. Release your head. Stack it back up. Once more. So right side. Shoulder roll and reach. Take that roll. Stack it back up. Other side, roll and reach and circle. Stack it back up in to the centre. We're going to bring palms up, elbows bent. Check in rib to hip if you've still got that neutral. So don't wait here. So you're just going to take the hand out and refold. So here you're focusing on opening through the collarbones, rather than squeezing the shoulder blades together, because if you squeeze, you pop the ribs forward. So you want to maintain that rib to hip connection as you just float the hands wide. So taking this to a Cleopatra, we take hands out, turn palms down, create new length. Refold, palms come up. Keep going here, so palms down, option, draw your ankle bones in and come up onto toes and refold. Keep going. So as you go, you should be able to breathe and breathe into that belly and that rib cage while still keeping that neutral. We'll go one more and then we're going to take this to a foot series. So from here, come up onto tiptoes, draw those ankle bones on, in, that switches on your bum. Summer through your knees, drop the heels, stand on it. And again, float, soften and lower. Keep going. Last one here, then we're going to reverse it. come low. Heels come up, lengthen. You can take the arms up this time and out if you want. So we come low, heels up, lengthen. Check into that rib to hip. Have you still got it? Or does it lengthen and the ribs pop as you take the arm overhead? So just check in. Last one. Lengthen, lower. Taking the feet out wide, toes on the angle. We're going to sink down. So pressing the knees wide, lifted through the arches. And if it all's collapsing in and you can't encourage out, just angle the toes further forward. So find your happy position. And we're going to take the arms out wide. We're pausing here. And then we're going to take this to a mermaid. So we're going to reach up and over with the left hand. Two arm circles. Sweep. And again. Feeding up and over. Mermaid the other side. So focus on pressing the ribs to the side. Two arm circles. Sweep. Nice big open circles. Back into the center. We're staying here. Come up if you need for the thighs, but if not, stay where you are. Arms are long, or you can shorten the lever if they don't like being out long. We're going to heel raise and lower at the side. Keep going here. Checking hip to hip. Are you still in that neutral? Have you got your tailbone stuck out? So try and lengthen that down. Keep going, I know it burns. Couple more, gotta get the legs nice and warm. Last one here, press the floor away. Staying in this open position, palms come up for our saw. So twisting round to the right. So left hand comes to either the knee or down to the foot, looking up past that shoulder. We're wrapping it out here. Press the floor away, come up, back into center, other side. So twist first, hand to opposite knee or ankle. Breathe. Press the floor away and come back in to center. Wiggle those feet in, half roll down. Chin to chest, imagine you're peeling down that imaginary wall. Hands come to thighs, soften the knees. Lengthen, look forward, arch that back, drop the shoulders away from the ears. Tuck it under for a cat. And then stack it back up, rippling up through the spine. Full roll down, chin to chest. Peel off that imaginary wall. Knees as soft as you need, release the head at the bottom. Just walking the hands over towards the right foot. Breath in and out. Other direction. Keep breathing. Back into center. Ground through the feet. Stack on back up. Roll up. And we've got a couple of shoulder rolls. And we'll get going. So we're going to start with an abdominal section. So you're at home, so you can make yourself as comfy as you like. So you might want a pillow through your head. I'll get one so I can cue you with that if you want it. So come down onto the floor. So as ever, there are always options. So you can keep your head down throughout and you might prefer that pillow there or without. You can come into abdo preps. If you're keeping your head off the floor while we do the exercises, then you need to imagine that peach between chin and chest. And you lead the movement by sinking the ribs down to the hips, rather than lifting with the chin, okay? So we want the ribs to do the work. Roll down, and that's your abdo prep. So take your position and do lead between the two if you need to. So weights as an option, and hands to side of head if you're coming to abdo prep position. So feet keep well away from bottom at the minute. Check you into that neutral, so you want to bring hips to ribs a little. And then we want to make sure that nothing then shifts through the center. As you continue to breathe, we're going to float one leg into tabletop and lengthen on a diagonal. Squeeze that thigh, keep going with the same leg. Lengthen, breathe out, breathe into there, and just make sure you're not withholding. Couple more. So you should find as you lengthen, the abdominals are kicking in to make sure nothing's moving. Fold back into single tabletop, leg down. Give your head a breather if you want to. And we'll go again on the other side. So reach between chin and chest, melt the ribs down to the hips, coming into that abdo prep position. Elbows nice and wide. If you float the other leg, tabletop. And then lengthen on the diagonal. Squeeze that thigh so the leg is active. Refold. So the lower you go, the more abdominal control you're going to have to keep that neutral, because otherwise you'll find the ribs are going to pop, or the back arch like here, and that's what we want to avoid. So rib to hip connection to keep that nice and strong as you lengthen and fold. I've got a really tricky hip on this side. I don't know if that we picked up on the mic. Breathe it out to lengthen, breath into the turn. Last two. Last one. Back in, lower head. So you might want cushion back in for this one, so we're gonna leave the head down. So we're gonna float one leg into tabletop. Rib to hip connection, float the second. Now if you find that the back arches as you kick that second leg up, scoop the heel into the bum as you pick it up. So you want to find your bite point here, okay? So if you drop your heels to your bum, you'll feel that less happens in the abdominals. As you float the legs up, you'll feel them kick in. So if that's too much and you feel like that back is arching, ribs popping, and you can't bring it back under control, or that sends pressure down to your pelvis, then just lower the heels towards your bum. If it's still not great, then pop one leg down and I'll try and remember to cue to squat the legs, okay? So options, weights into your hands. We're gonna float the weights up. I'm gonna start with bent knees. So focus as is ever on that rib to hip connection staying nice and strong. We're gonna get a coordination going here. So we're gonna go same arm, same leg. You're gonna keep knee bent and tap the both toe to the floor as you lengthen arm overhead and we fold. So you might decide you don't want the weights in your hands. See what works. We're sticking with the same leg. We go again. So breathe it out to lengthen, breath in to return. Keep going. So you should feel that abdominal challenge as you lengthen leg and arm. Two more this side and we'll go straight to the other side. If you find full range is too much, you don't have to tap the floor, okay? Other side. So we're tapping and floating. Breathe it out, breath in to return, but just make sure you're not breath holding. And you're in control of that rib to hip connection. Anchor the ribs down. If it's too much, smaller range. Don't tap to the floor. You should have a good quiver on with this one. Last two. Good work. Hug them in if you need to give your hip flexors a bit of a breather, and I'll just talk you through what we're going to do next. So we're going to say same option with knees bent, and we're going to do alternate arm and leg. And this always makes me think I have to move the leg a bit before the arm to get it. So we're doing the same thing but alternate arm and leg. And then once you're there, breathe it out, breath in to return. So I find this a lot easier than doing the same side. So it'd be interesting to see what you think. So you might feel that you can lengthen out further. Keep with the breath. Breathe it out. Breath in. Two more. Last one. And then we're going straight to the other side. So initiate it with the leg, get the arm length going. And you're aiming to keep the other leg and arm stock still. But again, mine have a tendency to want to join in. Breathe it out to lengthen. So I find it harder this side. Probably why I'm finding the other leg wants to join in. Keep with the breath. Work within your control, your range. Keep it going. Last two, if you can. Breathe it out to lengthen. Breath into the turn. Last one. And breath in. Draw the knees in. We've got one more in this position. Well, one more combo in this position and then we'll move, okay? So this time, we're going to work with a knee fold to the side. And we'll stick. We're going to take both legs together, okay? And we're going to go with arms as well. So let me just angle round a bit so you can see hopefully a little bit clearer. So you come back to your double tabletop. So you can keep knees bent. You're in control of that ribs hip connection. And we're going to float knees and you keep arms opening as far as knees can. So you don't just drop those to the floor. And you refold. Bring the knees together. Go again. So you're aiming for symmetry. And when you're at the end range, just see if you can squeeze an extra millimeter to feel that stretch on inner thigh and refold. So we can keep knee bent. Well, we will for this one actually. And we'll go one more round with legs long in a second. So lengthen, squeeze at the end, outer range, refold. Two more. So really squeeze those thighs open. You'll feel your glutes kick in. Squeeze back. One more. Squeeze. And refold. Feel free to draw the knees in if you want. We're going to go one more round of that. So you can stay exactly as we were, or you can lengthen legs out long. So we're going to have significantly increased abdominal demand of legs along, okay? So see, even if you can manage a couple of reps. So start ankles locked together, legs along, arms along, but shoulders nestled down to the floor. So we're going to refold. Again, see how symmetrical you can be with arms and legs. See if you can get an extra millimetre before zipping back up. And again. So you might find that hamstrings are not enjoying this. In which case, I'd say go back to bent knee option. Or somewhere in the middle, they don't have to be fully straight. Most importantly, you're in control of that rib to hip connection. So nothing's arching off the floor. Do you have that extra squeeze? You should have a quiver on. As you take it to your end range, keep breathing. Thighs are fully active. Last one. Back in. And give those knees a little roller or rock. How are we all doing? All right, I hope. And then come lie on your side to face me. Have your weight somewhere near. So, options on this one. We're gonna work into side and backward bend with this. So you can have head down. And again, you might want that pillow between head and shoulder. Or you can come props up onto your forearms. So take your option. Now normally we have feet in line with bum, but I'm going to bring you forward. So knees are facing me. So you've got a 90 degree at your hip and 90 at your knee. So press the floor away if you're up onto that shoulder and lengthen the head to the wall so you don't get a sore neck from holding it up. Option, weight into the top hand. So we're going to work with a parallel clam. So we're aiming on picking up that shin and lowering. So as you pick that leg up, make sure you don't collapse through the middle. You still want to think about that lengthening hip down and away. So it will block how far you can get, but now we're being nice and specific and abdominals are active. So L-arm, if you're adding it, elbow locked into your side, and we're going to, actually no, we'll lift up because I'll keep doing the wrong move otherwise. So picking up, so we should have knee and foot in the same line still. Pressure stays the same on the bottom leg, and I'm hoping you're feeling this everywhere around that hip. Keep steady breathing. And try and sneak that knee an inch higher. Two more here. And we're gonna add the clam level two, basically. So you float into this top position. You're gonna keep foot high as you dip knee low without collapsing through the middle. So just keep pressing the floor away. We come back to parallel. So we're dipping down with the knee, foot stays high, back to parallel. And again, keep going. So we should be firing up side and back of bum now. Knee down, toe stays high, back to parallel. Two more. Last one. Back into parallel, we're not done with this leg yet. Check you've not sunk, press the floor away. We're gonna lengthen this leg behind without letting the ribs pop. So pressure on this bottom leg should stay the same. And we're going to tap down to the floor, come up above hip height. So tapping down and lift. Imagine I've got that foot and I'm pulling it away from your body to keep that lengthen through the middle. So you should feel obliques working. You should be feeling into bum. If you're feeling it just front of thigh, draw the leg further behind. And breathe. Smiling. A bit too much to ask for. So we're going to hold that leg up, we're going to take arm overhead without sinking, keep pressing the floor, and we bring knee to elbow. We draw it in, lengthen, but you're lengthening that foot back. And again, draw it in, lengthen back. So everything should be feeling like it's getting a workout here. Keep breathing, breathe out to lengthen, breath in to return or just no breath holding. One more here. One final move, take the hand back up to the ceiling and we're gonna do a leg kick. So you're gonna sweep the leg forward, toes pointed. Don't collapse through the middle, keep drawing that hip away. Lead with the heel, press it back as far as you can keep those ribs under control. And we're still at hip height, not sinking. Put the toe, sweep forward, and press back. So this could be quite easy if you're not controlling the middle and you're just letting the whole body sway as you go. If you keep that stack at the front, you're gonna feel abdominals kicking in. And as you press back, bottom leg's working hard, ribs, abdominals working hard not to pop that leg. You're like, stop talking, this is burning. Last two, always two. Last one. Good work. We're bringing this leg up and over to the front. If that's not comfortable, just stick it forward, okay? Oh, that's a nice stretch. So turn to face that side. Couple of breaths here. And then just one twist the other way. And then grab your pillow if you had it, if you were laid down as an option. For the other side. So you're either relaxed down, head onto pillow between arm, or you're propped up. So we have feet So normally they're in line with bum, we're bringing them forward. So you've got hips and knees at 90. Grow out tall over that shoulder and lengthen head to the wall. Option, hand up like so. And then we're lifting and trying to sweep that knee high. So we're staying in parallel for this clam. So this often feels harder because the foot is just in fresh air, so we're not getting feedback. Normally we've got the ankles locked together. So check you've got that draw, so we're not sinking ribs to the floor. And of course we're breathing. Keep going. Right, in a second we're going to add on those knee dips down. So on your next one, we're going to hold it up there. So foot stays high, knee drops with control before bringing it back to that parallel. So keep the pressure on that bottom leg the same throughout. We're not collapsing through the middle. Nothing shifts there. Knee tap down, foot stays high. And lift back up with that knee. Good, keep it going. Couple more, and then we're going to lengthen out through that top leg, keeping it at hip height. Two more. Lift back to that parallel, last one. And parallel. So lengthen through that top leg. So make sure it's behind you a little, but not so much that it makes those ribs pop. So you've still got that rib to hip connection. And then we're coming down. And up. Keep breathing. Keep lengthening that head. I'm doing an awful job of that because I'm looking at the camera. Lift. Imagine I've got that foot. I'm pulling it gently to keep that lift out of that waist. Keep going. Keep breathing. I know it burns. You've got this. Last two, and we're adding that kick forward. And hopefully I haven't forgotten anything, because normally I'm like, guys, what have I forgotten? Float it to hip height or a little bit higher. Foot pointed, we kick forward, flex the foot, draw it back. Keep control of that rib to hip. And see how far you can kick back. Lengthen. Keep it hip height or higher. Going to want to drift to the floor. Should have a quiver on by now. Press and back. Keep going, couple more. Last one. Sweep and draw back. Lovely. We're going to sweep that leg up and either just in front or cross it over and then twist to that side. Aiming to have both of your sit bones down on the floor. And then just a little twist to the other side. And then we're going to come onto all fours. So, option to have a weight accessible for both hands. Come onto all fours and then do that couple of cat-cow movements. Uncurling through the spine. And again.
taking a weight into your hands closest to me. So you want knees nice and wide for this. Hands nice and spread. Fingertips nice and spread, sorry. And then check in with the hip. You've got your neutral, so it's nice flat back. With our hand, you're going to sweep it forward, keeping shoulder well open here, and press it back. Elbow nice and straight. So sweep forward, press it back. So we're aiming that you're not shifting one side to the other here. You should feel the front arm working hard. You should feel abdominals working hard. Couple more. Keep pressing the floor away. Last one. And sweep. Back off those wrists. And we'll go to the other side. So fingertips nice and wide, press the floor away. Check in with the hip, you've got that neutral. And then we're sweeping forward, nice step between shoulder and elbow, and press back. Keep going. Steady breaths. Two more. Keep pressing it all the way through that hand. Last one. Again. Give focus a little bit of a breather. Right, nearly done, guys. So we're going to come forward onto the hands and knees again. We're going to come down to forearm. You can have your hands interlaced with open space and fingers, whichever you prefer. But make sure elbows are hip width apart. From here, you've got your neutral, but then we're going to look forwards and press forward to the floor. So you might, I was a bit tucked up then, you might want your legs a bit further back. And then we're going to come back to that tuck position. So you want to think here about hips to ribs, to flatten that lower back, and press yourself back. We go again. So press yourself forward, you're in control of that lower back. You've still got that tuck under with the tailbone. Keep pressing the floor through the shoulders. And again, hip to rib. So you've got that flat back, abdominals should be feeling that. So this is all about having that control between pelvis and lower back. So keep that tailbone tucked under as you press forward. One more, because I know the shoulders are working hard here as well. So, if you collapse at the bottom, that's fine. You want to get that tuck under again. So tuck tailbone under, and then press it back. Tuck toes, bring the knees in, and press back to shell stretch and child's pose. And if you're happy kneeling, stay kneeling. You might want a pillow between bum and heels, or you can sit or you can stand, your choice. So seated cat-cow, so slide your hands forward and curl that spine. And then inhale, slide hands back up, shoulders drop, arch and look up. One more. Upper back stretch. So here you interlace hands. You bring them shoulder height and press them through. So the palms are now facing away from you. Breath in and out. Breath in here, sorry. As you breathe out, lower the hands down to the left and have a look. On your next in breath, just looking at the hands as you take them overhead. Keep the ribs under control here though. And separate and circle. And again, interlace hands up to shoulder height. Press the palms away, breath in. Breathe out, hands down, head down. Breath in, hands up, have a look. And exhale, separate. corkscrew. So you're going to take hands wide, hands behind head, elbows stay wide. Shrug shoulders up, release, and lower. And again. Shrug it up, and release. Hold it here, side reach. So keep your bum ground down to the floor if you're sat, or to your heels if you're kneeling. Back into centre, shrug it up, and release, other side. And back into centre, one final shrug up, and release, and lower. So rolling on up, so tuck those toes, weight onto your feet, and roll on up through the spine. And into standing. Another full roll down, chin to chest. Release your head at the bottom, knees as soft as you need. Release one heel, letting that knee bend. And then re-ground and release the other heel and knee. And re-ground. Strong through the feet, through legs, and roll on up through the spine. And we're done. I hope you enjoyed. As ever, let me know if you've got any questions, comments, and what you want next. And I'll be back with more. Thank you. Bye.